So, warm greeting to all. This session we are going to discuss problem on welded joint. So, here we are going to discuss problem 2. A rectangular steel plate is welded as a cantilever to a vertical column and supports a single concentrated load P as shown in figure. Determine the weld size if shear stress in the same is not to exceed 140 megapascal. So this is a given diagram. The load is applied at the end of the plate, P equal to 60 kilonewton, and then size of this plate will be given, that is 100, and this dimension is 150, and here to weld joint is 50 mm, and this is given data. Load P is 60 kilonewton and B is 100, breadth is 100, and then length is 50 mm, and thick tau is 140 megapascal, that is 140 into newton per 140 newton per mm square. So this is given, and this we have to draw. So from this center of gravity of the weld joint, so we have to mark this end to weld joint is R2, and this is R1, that is G to B is R1, this is theta, and this is also theta, and we have two shear stress, one is primary and another one is secondary shear stress. So that is primary is tau 1 and the secondary shear stress is tau 2. So the two shear stress is induced in this C type weld. So the distance between center of gravity to the end of the plate is eccentricity. So this x value we can take from the data book, PSG data book, and the problem will be discussed here. So the let S is weld size and T is throat thickness. So here in this problem we are going to find out the size of the weld. S we need to find, and the value of x which is equal to L square divided by 2L plus B. If you substitute the value of L and B, we will get the value 12.5 mm, and the polar moment of inertia of the C section will be given in the PSG data book. We have to find out and substitute the values and find out the value of polar moment of inertia, that which is equal to 275 into 10 power 3 S mm power 4. The distance of load from the center of gravity G, that is eccentricity. So we need to find out what is E value, that is E is the end of the load to the center of gravity of the weld, that is 150 plus the total is 50 minus of x value. So minus of x value, so if you substitute all the values, we'll get this 187.5 mm, the eccentricity value E equal to 187.5 mm, and R1, so this R1 which is equal to GB which is equal to 50 minus X, which is equal to 37.5 mm, and the AB value which is equal to 100 divided by 2, so 100 divided by 2 which is equal to 50 mm. And we know the maximum radius of the weld, so R2, so the R2, the hypotenuse, we have to find R2 which is equal to root of AB square plus BG square. So AB is 50 square and BG is 37.5 square. You can get the value of 62.5 mm. Then cos theta which is equal to R1 divided by R2 which is equal to 0.6. So the area of the weld A equal to 2 into 0.707 S into L plus 0.707 S into B. So one transverse, the parallel, double parallel fillet weld. So if you substitute the values, the area will be 141.4 S mm square. the direct or primary shear stress tau 1 equal to p by a load and s in terms of s we will get that is 424 divided by s newton per mm square. Then secondary shear stress that is tau 2 equal to p into e into r2 divided by j. So if we substitute the values we will get this 2557 divided by s newton per mm square. So we found tau 1 and tau 2. So we know that the resultant shear stress tau which is equal to tau 1 square plus tau 2 square plus 2 tau 1 tau 2 cos theta. So the theta value we already found that is cos theta is 0.6 and tau 1 which is equal to 424 divided by s and tau 2 equal to 2557 divided by s. We substitute these values and find the value of s that is size of the weld which is equal to 20.23 mm. So this is your size of weld in this particular problem. So thank you. The remaining things we will discuss in the next class.